Hello everyone, and welcome to the fifth edition of the Settlements and Survival Series. Today we're returning to our base from our first expedition, and we're going to basically finish this thing. We're going to turn our base into an actual settlement. We're going to go ahead and do our maintenance like normal. I'm going to cut that out. But we need to build ourselves a beacon, which we're going to build a beacon, and we're going to build a decontamination arch. We're going to wait for settlers to show up. We're going to plant some food, get them all established, get them all equipped, and then we're going to leave again. What we also have to do this time around is we have to upgrade our gear because it's long overdue. So here's our beacon. There's my light so I can see that it's on. The little light on the switch is usually not enough, so I use that cycling light. Now, after I built this, I realized I didn't have any copper. So I needed copper to build my decontamination arch. So I'm looking around, scrapping stuff, and lo and behold, two settlers show up. So I don't like red on the bar. And so what I'm going to do first here is I'm going to plant my standard six. We're going to plant the stuff we stole from Grey Garden. Three corn, three tato, three mew fruit, which incidentally is six food. It's the perfect adhesive mix, and it stays together pretty well. Now, what you'll notice here, if you're looking, is that there's already one food assigned. I have not planted anything. Now there's two, now there's three. What that is, that's two things. One, I forgot the melons and gourd were up behind the yellow house. I forgot to pull them up. Two, when you get new settlers, there's three different kinds you can get. One is just a generic settler. He's just like, they're just like, show up, yeah, hey, tell me whatever to do. The second one is a guard type settler. They're exactly the same as every other settler, except for one difference. If there are any unassigned guard stations in your settlement, they will automatically assign themselves to them when they arrive. The third type is a farmer. Farmers are the one who come with cows. They come with cows sometimes, the Brahmin. Farmers, what they do when they show up, is if there's any crops in your settlement, they will automatically assign themselves to six units if there's six units of crops. You'll notice I did not say unassigned crops. If you've been playing this game long enough, you've come back to the situation where you'll have settlers that are like working, they're like, why are you working these weird crops or whatever? Well, what happens is the new farmer comes in, assigns themselves to six, and kicks existing settlers off the crops. It's a total pain in the ass. So you'll have, like, say, three settlers with 18 food, and all of a sudden you'll have four settlers with 18 food. You're like, wait a minute, what the hell just happened here? So you'll notice that when I planted six food, right, she only assigned herself to five, even though technically there's seven here, right, the melons and all the stuff I planted. There's a little weirdness when they do this, when they come in with existing plants, right, and they don't max out right away, their maximum becomes whatever. It becomes six minus however much they assign themselves. It's like they're stuck, right? So she assigned herself to one when she came in. I gave her six more. She assigned herself to five because six minus one is five. She will never go above five until you clear her table. And you clear her table, her assignments, by sticking her on a guard station like I did. That's why I stick them on guard stations. Easy living. Well, that and, you know, they stay put so I can get them later. So here I'm going to go ahead and get the crops. A tip on storing crops in the workbench. Avoid storing crops that are assigned. Always make sure that the icon's red instead of green, because if the game has to unassign and store at the same time, it freaks out a lot, and you get ghost plants, you get settlers wandering around, always be sure to make sure whatever you're storing has been unassigned. You can scrap it, will, that's no big deal, but with plants, you have to store them. So I found the melons, got the gourds, checking. Oh, look, Carla's here. Excellent. I can get copper off of her. I go back, you saw that I built turrets, right? Well, the turrets take circuitry, and I use all my circuitry too, so now I need copper and circuitry to build my decon arch. Okay, so I got the plants up, I'm gonna assign her to these, and now I'm gonna wait. I know I've got six crops right here, right? So she's six. Now I double check, are all these green? Yes, okay, good. There are no more plants in this settlement that I missed, because she would go for those first, because they were here first. All right. So, she's assigned, she's set up, he's assigned, he's set up, got the beacon, turned off the beacon. Now we're going to eat, because we got to eat. Let's go grab the crap out of the filing cabinet that I've been saving to sell to Carla. We're going to go to sell to Carla. Now I'm going to go to her, sell everything I got, buy some power relay coils for the copper, buy some hot plates for the circuitry, make sure I got everything. And then once I get that done, I'm going to build myself a decontamination arch. So here it is. Stuck it here. Let's wire it up. Do my famous hide the conduits, conceal the conduits in the bushes there, and shortest possible pass, there's not a lot of wire. Hook it up, go back over here behind my generator, do my wire glitch with my nest, goes under the ground, and pop, and voila. Now I have no more radiation, and I sleep, And now it's time for me to upgrade my settlers. I'm going to give them the best guns I have. I'm going to give them the best armor I have. With the guard here, I'm going to make him look stylish. So I'm going to give him the drifter outfit, the militia hat. I like this combination. It looks really cool. Look at him. He's like, I'm a badass now. So now we're going to go to her. We're going to give her the rest of the stuff we got left. I like to put my farmers in road leathers because it's dark. And I know when I see road leathers, I know that they're dressed like that. Sometimes I'll use long johns. Sometimes I'll use whatever. But generally speaking, it's a flashback from when we didn't know what they did. I had to dress them to make sure I knew what they were doing. And that's just a habit I still have. So these people always get road leathers and leather armor or metal armor. So we're going to grab all our crap. We're going to leave our hat on. Another tip, if you can give your settlers different hats, it's easier to identify them later. And yeah, I gave her a bolt action rifle and forgot it takes 308 instead of 38. So let's go get that bullet, give it to her.
I just want to trade a few things.
Yeah, trade a few things. So we're going to give her a nice, big, heavy rifle. We're going to give her ammo, see if she equips it. Yes, she does. And now the rest of her armor and weapons and whatever. So now she's set up. She's good. I take all her stuff, put it in the workbench, put it back in my bucket here. And what am I going to do now? What am I going to do? Okay, now I'm like, okay, now I have to upgrade. Now my settlement's done. I have to upgrade. One thing I do not have at this point that I am missing greatly is I do not have a spotting weapon. Normally I have a long gun and a short gun, a sniper rifle and a pistol. That's how I roll, right? But one of the advantages of having a long gun is it has a scope on it. And I use the scope a lot to scout things out. So right here what I'm doing is I'm picking the lightest weapon I possibly can, which is a straight up pipe pistol. And look at that. Gun nut one lets me build a long scope. This gun I'm probably not going to use, but, I mean, like to shoot with, right? Because it's a pipe pistol with no mods, it's 13 damage. But what I can do is this. Now I can see. I can see up 100, 150, 200 yards. I can scout out locations before I get involved in stuff and see if it's worth it to go fight or whatever. So now that I have two guns, I'm going back to my 150, 150, except with the pipe pistol, I'm not going to bother with a bunch of ammo because I'm not going to use it very much. And now I'm upgrading my armor. I go to upgrade my armor. I need pocketed because we're gonna be exploring now. We're gonna be doing a lot more combat, a lot more fighting, a lot more scabbing, and we're gonna need a lot more stuff. So I'm looking to make this thing pocketed. I don't have any leather, but I have clothes in here, and a lot of these clothing pieces break down the leather. The only problem is you can't break them down to the armor workbench. So what you do is you take them out of the thing, drop them on the ground, scrap them. Leather, leather, cloth, leather, leather, leather. After a while, you'll get the hang of knowing which ones have leather for you. So I got some leather now, yay. Let's go upgrade my armor. And of course, this was a mistake. I did the left leg. The thing about pocketed and deep pocketed is it has, for pocketed, it gives you 5 more capacity on your arms and legs, but it gives you 10 on your chest. And I realize this now, and I'm like, can I move the mod over? Nah, I can't move the mod over. So yeah, that was a mistake. I'll get it later, I'm sure, once we kill some raiders. So we got that, now we're gonna see if we can make We can't make any adhesive, so I can't upgrade my chest piece. I'm really pissed off about not being able to upgrade that chest piece. Check for corn. Nothing grew yet. Okay. So we'll put everything away, and we will... what are we going to do here? Oh, yeah, I got to make food, too. Again, make everything in the bench. Just make all the meat, because you're going to need it. And that's pretty much all. So now she's prepped. She's got a new gun. She's got new upgraded armor. Everybody's set here. They're not going to get attacked. We're all good. Now our base is a settlement. We sleep, wake up, beacon's off, great. Everything looks good here. I'm gonna go ahead and get hydrated from the old water pump. Always gotta top off, make a habit of top off where you leave. And any corn? Nope. Okay. We're gonna hit the road. I'm gonna thank y'all very much for watching and subscribing. And we'll have some more action in the next one, which I will see you in. Take care.